What's going on, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and fellow YouTubers, all of you, I bid welcome to the Paladin-class Temporal Battlecruiser Aesthetic Review. And that is this ship that is right here behind me. Now, obviously, I am in the Dribble test server, and for all of you guys that have no idea what I'm talking about, I'm going to do a review on how to get to the Dribble test server. And the Dribble test server is just as it does, as the word is, it is a server for you to test stuff on. So I'm using the Dribble test server to obtain all of the reputation space sets, the one that we are not able, or I mean, we are able to get this temporal defense space set, but most of us don't actually have that yet. So you can obtain it on the Drozana station if you guys want to check it out for yourself. And I'm going to do a review how to get to the Dribble test server in a couple of days, so stay tuned for that. But anyway, the Temporal Battlecruiser, this is the Paladin class, like I mentioned before. Now what I'm going to do is, I already have this ship as my current ship. I'm going to go to the Soul sector and I'm going to try to customize, or at least see how much customization we can do with this thing. After that, we're going to go into space, then we're going to equip all of the different space sets on this baby and see how it is going to transform with all of the reputation space set and all of the various other sets. After that, hopefully it's going to feature a unique bridge. I have no idea. And after the unique bridge, we're going to take it into combat. So let's get to it. First of all, I'm going to go through the statistics of this ship, and I'm going to go through the statistics through arcgames.com. That is the official website for Cryptic. So, drawing inspiration from the 23rd century Ranger class, the Paladin class Battlecruiser is a very tactically focused, It features a potent weapons platform and a number of sophisticated maneuver systems, makes the Paladin a remarkable agile vessel for its class. This starship features a lieutenant tactical slash temporal operative and a commander engineering slash temporal operative bridge officer seat. Faction Federation and the 23rd century Starfleet TOS. It is available through the C store. It is a tier 6. A rank required to obtain this thing is a level 50 on the Federation side. A hull strength of 40,800 hit points at level 50 and 48,000 hit points at level 60. It has a shield modifier of 1.05. Four weapons on the front, four weapons on the aft, and three device slots. That is obviously always nice to have. The bridge officer stations, I'm going to skip. I'm going to showcase this into space. Well, we're going to do the space part of this video. Console modification, four tactical, four engineering, and two science. A base turn rate of 10 degrees per second. Impulse modifier of 0.15. Friction traction, that is the inertia rating of 55. Plus 10 to weapons and also plus 10 to engine power. A universal console, the heavy phaser assault platform. Also molecular reconstruction, so we have cruiser command array, shield frequency modulator, weapon system efficiency, and we have a battlecruiser starship ability package that's going to give up absorption plating, enhanced weapon banks, enhanced plating, armored hull, and retaliation. That is a starship trait. Nice. And obviously there is a fleet variant of this thing that is definitely the best thing you can get out of there, because it features just a little bit more statistics, or I mean just a little bit more more shielding, a better hull strength, better shield modifier. Let's run it through. Drawing inspiration, we already the Fleet Temporal Battlecruiser Tier 6 has been specifically designed to support your fleet. Fleet starships are built to the highest standard and have increased hull hit points, shield strength, and additional console slot, like I just said. Tier 6 fleet ship do not have a 5th starship mastery level and thus will not unlock the starship trait. But if you have bought this thing through the Zen store, you can basically level it up and then take that retaliation starship trait, and you can put this thing into whatever you want to in your character. So this starship features a lieutenant tactical slash temporal operative and a commander engineering slash temporal operative bridge officer seat that we already mentioned before. So nothing has changed on the faction. It still requires you to be a Starfleet or a TOS character. It is a tier 6. It's available if you have the shipyard at tier 5. Required level still at level 50. A hull strength that has been changed of 45,540 at level 50 right here. That is awesome. And 52,800 hit points at level 60. It has a shield modifier of 1.155. Four weapons in the front, four on the aft. Three bridge officer. Three device slots. A console modification of 4 tactical, 5 engineering. So you get an extra engineering console and 2 science. A base turn rate of 10 degrees per second, impulse modifier of 0.15, friction and traction that is obviously 55, so that hasn't changed, that inertia rating. Also turn weapons to 10 engines, that is always nice to have. Molecular reconstruction, obviously command cruiser array. So shield frequency modification, modulation, weapon system efficiency, that hasn't changed. And it only has the Starship ability package for Battlecruiser all the way to level 4, not to level 5. So keep that in mind. These are basically all of the Universal Console. And the one that we're going to feature is this one right here. The heavy phaser assault platform. So the tier 6 temporal battlecruiser comes equipped with a heavy assault platform universal console. When this ability is activated, the battlecruiser will deploy a platform that is bristling with overcharged phaser array. After a few seconds, it will begin fire devastating blasts of phaser fire at nearby foes. After a short time, the platform will trigger a self-destruct sequence. Nice! If it isn't destroyed before the sequence is completed, it will cause massive kinetic damage to nearby foes. This console provides a passive boost to phaser damage and projectile damage. This console mod can be equipped on any temporal battlecruiser and may be equipped in any console slot. Also retaliation as a 26th century starship trait. After achieving level 5 in your temporal battlecruiser tier 6 starship mastery, you will unlock retaliation starship trait. While the trait is slotted, you will suffer a critical hit, you will gain a boost to your weapon damage and critical hit system. This buff stacks up to 3 times, so you're going to do more critical damage if you suffered a critical damage. Kind of weird. But I guess that is what it's called, retaliation. Nice, nice, real cool. Now, my ship should be installed. There we go. So we're going to go into Earth space stack just a little bit so we can see what kind of customization we can do to this battle cruiser. And that is the Paladin class. That is nice. Kind of reminds me of right off the bat of the Jonathan Archer Enterprise, because it has like that flat design, you know, just a buffed up version of that. It's really flat. The nacelles are basically at the same height of the saucer section, so That is just my personal opinion, obviously, and everybody is entitled to one, right? But anyway, we are going to go to the customization NPC, and that one is right there. And let's see how much customization options there are on this thing. You obviously are going to customize your ship the way you like it. Now, I'm not going to go into too much details. So we only have the template of the Paladin. I haven't unlocked any other templates. Maybe it's like bound or linked with the other C-Store items. I haven't unpacked the other ships yet. This is just the first one that I have unlocked. And that the Daedalus tier 2, but I guess those aren't really... okay, so it features its own unique bridge. Nice. We're going to feature this as well. So only one type of windows. And really cool to see this like half deflector dish. Real cool to see this. I like it. So we have different material types. This is material type number one. Oh, okay, the deflector dish kind of changed. Can we zoom in a little bit? No? No. This is as far as we can zoom in. And we also see a little bit of change, or at least this grabbed my attention right away. This was like greenish. Now it's like bluish. Cool. Ew. Don't like this part. This is material type number two. Lots of escape pods. Wow, a lot of escape pods. What the hell, man? Is this thing gonna blow up anytime soon? Material type number three. Cool. Real cool. And I do love the shadow effect that they're bringing on in this customization part. As you guys are seeing right there. You can see the sunlight emitting a little bit of shadow on that. Oh, wow. I'm definitely a sucker for these kind of changes right here. Ooh, even these things. I have no idea what these are, but even those are real nice. I think those are like the impulse... output impulse engines. Nice. Type 4. Type 5. Here we go. A little bit of a normal material types. Type 4. Oh, wow. Look at this. This, I thought that this was like a dome on the outside, but it's a dome on the inside. Look at that. The arc is like curved inwards on the hull, on the saucer section right there. It's like curved inwards. Nice. Real nice. Six, material type number six. It's too bright for me. material type number seven. Oh my God, I love this. Oh wow, this is awesome. Oh, this is my favorite material type, number six right here. Oh, wow, this is gorgeous. It is a gorgeous looking ship right there. Material type eight, that is the default stock version. And come to think of it, kind of is like greenish, yellowish, whitish tint. The upgrade variant, upgrade. Don't really like it. Veteran. Wow, definitely love the veteran upgrade. Now the veteran is because I'm a lifetime member as of late. And one of you guys wrote a comment on the previous videos, you are kicking yourself because they have a discount in lifetime membership mint. Yes, I am, because I didn't get the discount. No, I'm not. I mean, I had to buy the game. I mean, it's treated me well, and why not pay the full price? So I don't mind paying the full price, not having the discount. I'm gonna go with Type 8, because that is what most of you guys are going to fly this ship with, or at least the ones that have bought this thing. Obviously there is an advanced feature where you can do pattern overlays on the hull, just like this, and then basically change the color configuration to whatever is going to be your liking, something like that. Just to showcase that it is possible. It is not something that I'm going to go with. Now obviously I'm going to cancel all of the changes that I made to my ship, because I want just the default skin, default variant, and I'm gonna go into space right now. So we're going to equip all of the different spacing sets that this thing is going to change the way it appears to be right here. And it is always fun to see. Now obviously these two fireworks type deal going on right there at the engine wake, that is just a buff that is not part of this video, so keep that in mind. That is just a buff that I currently have selected, a trait. Oh no, not a trait, it is from the it is called pedal to the metal. It is from the specialization. Is it Intel? I have no idea. I have to look it up. I always keep forgetting what kind of buff that is, or where it is located, I mean. Now this is just the normal default skin. As you guys, whoa, I can zoom in real close right now. That is crazy. Lots of details on this thing, and I do love the way that this ship is that this ship is flying right now. But just to be real, just to make sure that you guys understand me real quick, there is no changes to the visuals when you have a different version of this ship. Now obviously there the fleet variant is not going to change the skin of this ship, it's just going to add one constant slot and a lot of like hit points, you know it's going to upgrade this ship, but it's not going to upgrade the appearance of this ship, so it doesn't really matter for the visuals on this thing. It's really good to see this thing, real flat out ship. Right there you guys can see the cross section of this thing, it's really flat, and that is why it reminds me of the Jonathan Archer variant of the Enterprise. Now the default Mark, I always call it Mark 10, but it's not the Mark 10, it's just the default skin. Real cool to see. So here we go, let's start with the adaptive Mako space set. There we go, the adaptive Mako space set. And I do want to zoom in just a little bit so you guys can see how it is. All of these finer details. I do love that they made changes to these domes. Nice animation right there, and really cool to see that they also did a little bit of work on the deflector dish itself right there. It has like that honeycomb type deal going on. Hexagons. Real cool to see all of these details on this ship. Nice. Oh wow, look at that, that is transforming right there. That is awesome. As you guys might know, the ones that are watching my videos on like on a daily basis, I do love these transitions when the ship actually transitions from one part of the sunlight to the dark side of the sunlight. That is just awesome for me. I am really absolutely crazy about that. moving on to the edges, a space set. Aegis space set makes this ship look like this. Lots of details are coming to life, like whitish contours all over this ship. Real cool to see how it is transforming. Real nice white lines all over these nacelles and struts that are there. Wow. Nice animation right there from the deflector dish. Real cool. Wow. Nice. I do love this thing. The Borg have assimilated this ship, and it's going to make this ship look like this. Look at that. Oh, that's awesome. Ooh, really big deflector dish on the bottom part of this ship. And it doesn't go all the way through. That's cool. That is awesome to look at. I always love this thing. Let me just zoom in a little bit. There we go. So we can see all of these nodes. Right there from the universal console. A really big deflector dish, and it is kind of outside of the hull, but it doesn't really matter, I guess. Same is for the boost to the engine, or at least the impulse engine. And there is a visual stuff thingy on the on the warp nacelle right there. Nice. Looks good on with the Borg space set. And obviously when we're going to equip the Borg space set on our ship, there is a visual bug right there. That is because that is why the Earth is, like, you know, being assimilated right there. Next one up, Counter Command space set. 1, 2, 3. Counter Command space set. As of late, this space set has kind of surprised me a lot with, you know, these ships, and it still is. I mean, this thing is awesome as it is looking right there. It's cool. It is definitely in the top 5 of my personal preferences, and it is gorgeous to look at this thing. Now, that is obviously just the lit version from the sunlight. Now, obviously, I'm also going to show when this thing is not facing the sunlight, just like that. Wow. Nice. Look at that, the darkened version of this thing. Kind of loses just a little bit of the appeal. And I see I forgot to remove the universal console from the Borg right there. That is why you are seeing these lights up here. But it's cool. It's nice. These details right here, and I especially love this part right here on the forward part of this saucer section. Definitely love it. Let me just remove you for further purposes. Delta space set up for grabs next. And most of you are talking in the comment section below that you don't want to see those space sets that don't actually change the ship's appearances. That's always nice. So we're going to save up time for that, and we're not going to equip that. So that's always cool to understand you guys a little bit more. Because this is why I'm doing it for you guys, right? I'm doing it for you guys so you guys can have a little bit of knowledge, a little bit of entertainment coming out of this channel, and actually make a choice if this ship is good for you or it's not good for you based on this video, obviously. So the Delta space set kind of makes this thing look slick. It's really neat. It's really streamlined. And you guys can actually understand one thing if you're watching this video. I do read all of your comments, but I don't have time, or I don't always have time to leave a response in return. But I do read all of them. That is obviously cool. Nice, the Delta space set. I do love these red lines that are emanating from the Delta space set. Here we go with the Dyson. Oh wow, Dyson. One of my personal favorite space set out there, the Dyson space set. Look at this. Isn't this awesome? Look at this. Oh, that transition there is just gorgeous for me. I can look at this thing for hours and hours. And I'm going to zoom in just a little bit right here so you guys can actually see the transition. It's like all of these details are coming into life right there. So you kind of see a bone-like structure on this thing. It has like a little bit of veins. And I do love it. All right, let me just zoom out just a little bit so you guys can see the full ship and how it looks like. Nice. Real cool. Real nice to look at this thing. Dyson space set, obviously one of my personal favorite, like I mentioned before. Iconian space set. 1, 2, 3. And this is how it looks like with the Iconian space set. Not really on the foreground, just a little bit up here. What is up with this? And a little bit down there. Huh. Okay, I was expecting just a little bit more details, but it is what it is. Obviously, we are seeing, oh, okay, up here. Here we go. These are all of the details from the Iconian space set. So we kind of see a lot of, or not a lot, a little bit more than on top of the saucer section. We see a lot of details from the Iconian space set, and even in these struts that are holding the warp nacelles in their place. Nice animation right there, and also a nice engine glow or engine wake from the Iconian reputation from space. Awesome. What else? Okay. Okay. The Gem Hadar. Nice. Here we go with the Gem Hadar space set. Real nice to look at this thing. Real cool. Oh, it totally changed the vibe of this ship. Look at this. I like this even more right now. I mean, the Gem Hadar space set is like making this pinkish glow. It's like, you know, it's like girly. But I do love it. I mean, it is totally something different, like the Dyson one or the Delta. And I guess that's obviously because this, like, you know, it's featuring something else totally. And it's nice. Look at this. I do love that they inverted these domes, so it's like a so it's like inside of the hull, and you kind of see these really bright pinkish lines that are just awesome to look at. And obviously a nice engine wake in purple from the Jem'Hadar space set. Nice. Okay, so the Kobali doesn't offer any changes to the visuals, so I'm going to skip that. The verdict isn't still in with the Mako and the adaptive Mako. I don't know if there is or there is not any changes to this thing in visually, if they're just the same version. So I don't know if I should or should not display this thing. Maybe you guys can help me out, because some people say that there are differences, some people say that there are no differences. Maybe you guys can let me know in the comment section below, what should I do? Should I feature both of them, the adaptive and the normal Mako, or just one and then skip the other one due to its time? Because these videos are going a little bit like close to an hour, and some of them are over an hour long, and I don't know if you guys are watching the entire video or not, or just like skipping through. So the Kobali we're not gonna do, we're going to do the new Kara, because that is always a fun to look at. Here we go with the new Kara space set. So that is awesome, and I do see these red lines appearing again that are cool to look at. And this one also has a red line on the saucer section on top, and on the bottom it has from the deflector dish all the way to the top, and going to the aft of this ship. Nice. It's like, if you look at from a distance, it's like this thing has like cracks all over, needs some maintenance to fill in all of these cracks on all over this ship. It's nice though. I mean, I do love it somehow. It's totally different. Like, if you guys want to fly this ship with one variant and then the next day with another one, you can, why not? Star Trek is allowing you to do that. The Omega space set from the Borg reputation, or not the Borg reputation, the Omega reputation, right? Yeah, Task Force Omega reputation. That is where you can get these space sets. Nice engine output right there. I always enjoy seeing rocket exhaust into space. And this part here, right here, it's really nice. And underneath as well, cool. So you kind of see like rivets, like, you know, it's like a zippered kind of type deal going on. Nice, nice, real cool. And most of these space set obviously are changing just subtle details on these ships that are just awesome to look at. Real cool, real cool. Real nice to see these things. Okay, here we go. Kobali, no changes. The quantum phase, no changes. The Riemann does feature a change in this ship, and it's a good change, or at least for me it is a good change. And oh wow, Oh wow, look at this. This is awesome. This is awesome. This ship is awesome to look at with the Riemann space set. It's totally something different that we haven't actually seen in Star Trek Online, or you're not supposed to look at something like this. This is gorgeous. And I do love that they, usually you get like with the Riemann space set, you get like these hexagon type deal right there when the, where the engine is like lit up just a little bit. You kind of see it all over the place. So there is a, visual appearance on that, on the hull. But right now you guys are seeing this, not a lot. It's just right here. That is just cool to look at. That is awesome. So we are going to do the Romulan space set next. Obviously nice to have the Romulan space set. Wow, nice. Real cool right here. Nice. Awesome. It is really, really good to look at this thing. Nice. Awesome, awesome. This is the Romulan space set, and it features the temporal battlecruiser, and I have named mine the Baron. It was just something random that popped up. The soul defense, no changes to that one either. The Solanae, no changes. So we're going to skip both of them, and we're going to go with the Terran space set. Terran and also the Terran shieldings. So this is how it features with the Terran space set. Now obviously those sparks, firework type deal going on at the aft of this ship. It's not part of this ship. But since I am equipping a different engine, it kind of resets the buff that I currently have, like I mentioned before. So this is how it looks like with the Terran space set reputation from the Terran reputation. Nice. Really nice. And I see that they kind of limited the amount of light that this deflector dish is spewing out. So it's really cool to look at this thing, and really, really nice to look at. Terran reputation, nice. Real cool. And obviously the subtle changes that it's making right here, it is glowing this thing orange. Real cool to look at. Nice. Real cool. Real awesome. Okay, next one up. Which one? The Solanae, no, it doesn't feature anything. The Breen. The Breen space set is one before last that we're going to feature. Here we go with the Breen space set. Look at this. Nice. We are seeing these lines up here, the red one, the detail, and also on top of the saucer section. Real cool. These lines have been featured in a couple of space set. I don't know if that's by default or that is something that they're, you know, trying to do. But it features this ship, and it is looking real good. With the Breen's base set, that is just awesome. That is just good to look at this thing. It's kind of like, you know, some people are like comparing this thing to old newspapers that are like wrapped around this thing, like a paper mache kind of type deal. But to me, it's like, you know, it's like has like an industrial kind of look, especially right here. It's like, you know, rebars and like tubing and stuff like that that isn't actually done correctly. So it's always nice to look at this thing. Nice. So we kind of featured all of the space sets right now that we are currently are allowed to have in Star Trek Online. One thing that we didn't feature is the temporal defense, and we're going to do that right about now. So you guys can see this is a temporal defense space set, the one that we are currently working on obtaining in Star Trek Online. And wow! Wow, this thing is really nice when it's like, okay, so when it's lit up, it's not really appealing to me, but that's just my personal preference. But it is appealing when it's not lit up by the sun. So I do like it. And especially this deflector dish when it's like a disco ball. Some of you have said that in my comments in some of my videos. It's like a disco ball, so that's cool. And obviously that engine animation right there, that's always nice to have, so that's cool. What else definitely love this inverted like dome type deal going on that is like featuring some futuristic lightning. And that's cool. That is definitely cool to look at, this thing. Lots of, I don't know if this is a hint or not, but lots of, you know, these life support crafts that are right there. I don't know if that's a hint. This thing is going to be squishy, but I don't think so. I mean, it's going to survive a lot. But anyway, so that was all of the space visuals on this thing. Now I'm also going to cover the Starship Mastery. Now obviously all of these numbers are going to vary from captain to captain, from player to player, based on your skills, abilities, traits, your consoles, and whatever ship you're going to utilize, like, you know, beams or cannons and stuff like that. So don't hold the numbers that I'm going to mention right up to the actual numbers that it's going to feature for you. But anyway, so physical and kinetic damage resistance rating for level 1, so plus 25 physical kinetic damage resistance for level 1. Level 2 is going to increase your critical severity by 15%. And level 3 is going to give you enhanced hull plating energy and radiation damage resistance. So plus 25 all energy damage resistance rating, and also plus 25 radiation damage resistance rating. Level 4 is going to increase your maximum hull hit points by 10%. Real cool. And the retaliation, that is that level 5 active space trait that you can unlock. So when critically hit, stacks up to 3 times plus 10% all damage for 15 seconds, and also is going to increase plus 1 critical chance for 15 seconds. So each time you're going to get hit by a critical hit, there is a chance for you to gain these buffs. Now the statistics, I'm not even going to mention, and the loadout, not even the visuals, not even, but I'm going to cover this part again. So 4 weapons on the front, 1 deflector, impulse, a warp and shield, and also 4 weapons on the aft, 3 device slots, engineering, 4, this variant has 4 engineering slots. Now the the fleet variant has like 5 engineering, 2 consoles on the science, and 4 tactical consoles. Station, bridge officer stations, lieutenant universal station that has 2 abilities, obviously, a lieutenant commander tactical station, a commander engineering / temporal ops station, and lieutenant tactical / temporal ops station right here, and a lieutenant lieutenant science station right here that is going to feature these ships. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put these bridge officers up here just to have a little bit more survivability in space combat that I'm going to do. Yeah, let's do this one. Why not? Why not? All right. And a little bit more firepower if we are able to do that. Yeah, that's good. I obviously don't recommend you guys using this ship or this build. I do recommend using this ship, but not this build, because this build is just something that I put up together because I want a little bit more firepower, obviously. And when right now I'm also going to bring up my powers, because I also want to display these unique ability from the universal console that I didn't actually cover. And this is that universal console, the heavy phaser assault platform. Now obviously these statistics are going to change, so don't hold me to these statistics, but plus 15% mine and torpedo damage, plus 15% phaser damage deploying heavy phaser assault platform. So creates a level 60 heavy phaser assault platform for 40 seconds. What? Okay, that's weird. Are you guys... creates a level 60 heavy phaser assault platform for 40 seconds for 35 seconds. So which one is it? For 40 seconds or for 35 seconds? Anyway, heavy phaser assault platform... 581.2 phaser damage for per seconds up to 5 targets within 10 kilometers. After 30 seconds begins self-destruction sequence. So self-destructs after 5 seconds cooldown. What? 11,516.3 kinetic damage, 100% shield penetration up to 5 targets within 3 kilometers. 7.5 repel up to 5 targets within 3 kilometers. What? So if you put a gravity well somewhere and have this thing blow up, wow. 11,516 kinetic damage with 100 shield penetration. Skill that affects this ability, Starship long range targeting, reduces damage penalty from distance. And improve weapon damage, that is the weapon training. Cool. That is awesome. We are also going to feature the unique bridge of this thing, and it's always nice to look at this thing because the developers have made like a small unique bridge that is going to be featured on I think all of these ships. I don't think that they made like individual bridges, so it's going to be featured on all of these 26th century ships. So the Paladin class is going to have that. Which one is the other ones? The Sagittarius class. The Theseus class, because I kind of have it like all the way opened up, so I kind of the Nautilus class is going to feature this bridge. Wow, this is like, this is awesome. This is really awesome. Look at this thing. This thing is, what this thing is like, futuristic as crazy. This is awesome. Now obviously this bridge is just a a small map that is going to represent this this bridge, just a small map right here. Now in like most of these bridges, and I say most because Star Trek just gave us a bridge that also features a crew deck and stuff like that, that it's going to change. but most of the bridges, like 99% of all of the bridges that are featured with like ships, don't have a unique interior. So just the bridge and nothing else, right? But so this thing is featuring this kind of bridge. Wow, I do love this part. There is like, you know, in Deep Space Nine, there is like that section when where Chief O'Brien usually goes into to fix stuff. Kind of reminds me of that. Oh, this is nice. I like this part right here. This is truly nice. So the center part is where you can do everything, I guess. So you can select account band, library files, duty officers, and also a small craft. You kind of need to say, there is no seat for me up here. What is up with the world? No seating feature for this ship. Anyway, leave this ship because we want to feature it in a patrol mission. And by default, I'm going to do the Argala patrol mission wanted. So we kind of need to go to the Delta Quadrant for that. And I'm going to go right through the planet right there. That is nice. Argala Patrol, here we come. And let's use our quantum slipstream drive to gain access to that thing real fast. Now, obviously, this thing features like these what's it called, molecular deconstruction beam. So there is an offense, defense, or support feature that you can choose, and obviously this is something that Cryptic has put up, so that's always nice to see how this thing is going to develop, what kind of strategic purposes it's going to have down the line, because people are not really, you know, familiar with these features as of now, but they are going to. I mean, we do learn real fast, and we kind of are going to utilize those things to our advantage really, really fast. but anyway, here we go. Wanted. So I'm gonna go offensive. I'm not going to zoom out a lot because you guys do want to see this thing in action. So let's target this guy. Now obviously I'm not going to do enough damage to these guys. My weapon power is at default number 15. No consoles that are going to increase my damage overall. No skill from space haven't been set up. No time for doing skills, man. It's crazy, right? But this is how it turns like a normal battle cruiser, I guess. You know, well, it's kind of doing even a little bit more damage than normally. Normally I get like 2 digits, now I'm gonna get 3 digits, so that's nice. Now obviously these guys are like shooting at the enemy as well, so that's always nice to have friends. I guess. Oh, right there. Now, unfortunately, I don't have gravity well on these guys, but let's see that unique universal console feature that's going to deploy the heavy phaser assault platform in 3, 2, 1. There we go. Okay, so this thing is like stationary. Ooh! What? It's using beam fire at will? Wow! Oh wow, this thing is awesome. Nice. I also got blown to bits and pieces. Do I have hull healing somewhere? I should have hull healing somewhere. Let's do that. Why not? Let's feature this molecular deconstruction beam. I have it on offense, so it's going to take care of this guy real fast. Look at that. 1000 damage times 3, so this guy is almost dead and dying. So my hull is back to 100%. That's always nice. To be honest, this thing is now, obviously my shielding and my weapons aren't really upgraded to the maximum version of these things. These are just, you know, phasers that are just the default mark that come equipped with the normal default variant of these things. I do want to say one thing. I mean, this ship isn't squishy at all. I mean, it's surviving real good. Obviously I don't have the necessary skills, like I said, like I mentioned like gazillion times right now, but it is definitely a battlecruiser. I definitely recommend you guys using this thing. Why not? If you are able to obtain it through the C store, obviously upgrade it to the fleet variant, and grab a hold of this thing as fast as you can, because if you're into battlecruisers, definitely use this thing. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to deploy this platform again right here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to keep it alive. For 30 seconds, and then let's see if it's going to blow up. Okay, so it's pulsating right there, meaning it's going to, there we go. Is it gonna blow up? 5, 4, 3, you're gonna see a number up here. 2, 1, boom. Oh wow, that was good. That was good. Oh wow, I am one that loves these visuals, these eye candy. Nice. Can you let me go with that tractor beam? God damn it. Stupid torpedo. So definitely love this thing. This is really awesome. If you're into battlecruisers, definitely get this thing. It features four weapons on the front, four on the aft. Definitely a lot of survivability, especially with the fleet variant. You're gonna get an extra engineering console and also 4 tactical, so you can dish out, you know, enough damage to make a difference. So so I hope you guys have enjoyed this little aesthetical review for this ship, this battle cruiser, and it is awesome. I mean, I'm liking it a lot. You know, what else can I say? I mean, I think I covered everything. Temporal battlecruiser, always nice to have. I hope you guys have enjoyed this little part. I hope you guys have a little bit of entertainment coming out of this channel, and hope to see you on the next one. For now, I'm just gonna say take care, later.